Good morning. It is early, as usual. It's about 3 o'clock. It's actually 2:45, and I'm gonna roll here in about 20 minutes. I'm here now, over in Indiana, towards Indianapolis, but actually further, I guess south. And I just picked up a load yesterday, last night, about 10 hours ago. All right, and now I'm headed to Alabama, and then Alabama, I'm gonna go to Arkansas. Getting closer to Texas. All right, guys, stay tuned, be safe. I'm gonna try to record on the way out. I'm at a little truck stop here, and it is very awesome, actually. It's a lot of room, really great staff. They have showers for 15 bucks a night, but you know what? You gotta do what you gotta do. And they have fresh coffee that they do not charge, so that's kind of cool. So if you look at that, maybe your shower is about 12 bucks, right? Because you're not gonna pay for coffee. All right, guys, stay tuned. We are rolling sweet home Alabama. That's where we're going, folks. And then we are headed to Arkansas. It appears they're getting me closer and closer to my home time. We're only carrying 39,000. Real close to 40. Thanks for joining me, folks. It's a good night. No wind at all. It's 41 degrees here in Indiana. And I want to give a shout out to my new subscriber. You had messaged me about U.S. Express. Now, of course, I work for Variant. It's a totally different division. But I sent you the information for the Variant supervisor recruiter. She's in charge of all the other recruiters. So she's a good person. Her name is Connie. Let her know that you talked to Bud, or that you and I had messaged each other through YouTube, whatever you want to do. And she will guide you in the right direction. I promise you that. She's very good. And she'll respond to you very fast. And if you have any more problems or any questions, you know, like I said, I'm not with U.S. Express, but I can find out. I know they have orientation places. There's one in Springfield, Ohio, and I'm not sure about the other places, to be honest with you. But I will find out if you still need help. So I'm gonna go ahead and start my night drive. Man, there's a diner right there. Austin Diner on the right side. And I was hoping they were open. I came here just for that diner, and they were closed. They've been closed since the pandemic. All right, guys, here we go. Thank you. of Mont Eagle, but I don't believe we're going to see Mont Eagle today. We're only going to jump on 24 for a couple miles. Have made it successfully and safely to Hartselle, Alabama. All right, we're off the exit. Well, we're almost off the exit here, and we're gonna go a couple of miles, maybe about 4 or 5 miles, and then hopefully I'll find this place. Small town, Alabama. My truck is as tall as these buildings, it seems. This is when you want to see another tractor trailer come in the opposite direction. Now there's a box truck coming up. He's probably as tall as I am. All right, let's hope that 31 allows me to swing wide left. If not, we're gonna have to go straight and try to find another route. I think we're gonna be okay, as long as I get out of this little town area. Should be fine. Dream for me. And it is. Now we're taking a left turn here. I'm guessing right where those cars up there, where that truck is coming out. All right, that's a good sign. Shack, which is a good sign.
You have reached your destination.
I'm gonna park right behind this guy. Figure out what we're doing. There's no guard in there. That's fantastic. Shipping receiving to the right. All right, I'm gonna park right here and I guess creep on up, see what we got. I want to do a better parking job. I don't feel like sticking out like a sore thumb. And then the next driver behind me is going to have an issue. Just got to be careful backing up, especially when you're in a tight spot like this. Okay, he's moving up a little bit for me, which is very kind. He's good if he stops. I'm fine too, right here. Let's see what he's gonna do. I'm early. All right, he's gonna stop right here. Very cool. All right, let's go check out what we got. All right, we are door number 8. Very nice people in here in Alabama. Very nice guys. All right, so we're gonna have to do a little loop-de-loop. We're going back in this bad boy. Got a lot of room here. So you might as well do it the way you're used to doing it. Other than looking like a fool. I mean, you could easily do it almost semi-blindsided, but there's really no reason when you have all this room. So we're gonna go right there in door number 8. Going to open my doors real quick. One of those docks where you got to put yourself on the yellow lines to be lined up to the dock perfectly. Video, you have mostly of listening to music and looking at traffic as I drive through the dark morning hours until sunrise. You know, it's now about 8 o'clock in the morning. Pretty good tunes, so I hope I'll get a copyright for that. But anyway, it's a beautiful day, good drive. Some crazy drivers out there, some semi-truck drivers that should not be driving a truck, but it is what it is. So right now I am here and they're unloading me as we speak, and we're going to a place in Stevens, Alabama. I've never been there before, but I'm sure my GPS has. Stevenson, Alabama. So we're gonna go there, and it's a preloaded trailer. Now, I usually don't do drop and hooks, so I notified my ops manager by the laptop or by the tablet, and I asked if this is a drop and hook or not. I kind of hope it isn't, because I like this trailer. But it is what it is. And then after that, we can pick it up anytime today before 11 o'clock in the morning. So we have a couple hours to do it. And I have about 5 hours left on my clock before I gotta shut down. So I'll travel a little bit and then shut down. And then tomorrow I'm gonna sleep in, because this isn't due, or that next load isn't due in Arkansas until 11 o'clock in the morning. And it's only about 500 miles away from Alabama. I'll probably drive about 200 miles after I get this load. So that way tomorrow when I wake up, I only have about 300 miles to go. And that's about 5 hours worth of driving like I do every morning. So I'm getting used to that, not a problem. All right guys, well thank you so much. And if you haven't hit that thumbs up button, come on, hit that thumbs up. I appreciate everything, you guys. I'm at 702. Thank you so much, subscribers. You guys are awesome. Any questions you have about Variant, you know, let me know. I know I spoke earlier about US Express. I can tell you a little bit about US Express, but not everything, like where the orientations are set, because I know they do have them, I believe, in Jacksonville, Florida. I know for a fact they have them in Springfield, Ohio. So I'm sure there's other locations, you know. But I can definitely refer a good supervisor of a recruiter, and her name is Connie. So give me a heads up and I'll give you her information like I did previously with a subscriber. So, all right, so as they're unloading me, I'm gonna go inside and use the restroom and have a cup of coffee because I'm really tired. I'm not tired really, but I like to be more alert than I am, if that makes any sense, because I'm pretty alert, but. Anyway, the weather's gorgeous out here. It is 57 degrees, so it's very nice out here. All right, matter of fact, when I get to Texas, I wanna try out that store called Bucky's. And Bucky's is like a travel center, but I believe it's mostly for vehicles, not for trucks, you know, for cars and pickup trucks, not for semi-trucks. But I'll drive up there in a car and I'll get out this GoPro somehow without looking like I'm crazy and videotape Bucky's, because I definitely want to do that. That'd be really cool. And we're going to head out to Stevenson, Alabama. All right, very awesome. I just popped in some sunflower seeds and they started unloading my trailer like, what, 15 minutes ago, and they're finished. All right, so I did call Variant and they told me the preloaded, of course, is drop and hook. I knew that term. You just always got to make sure, because usually they put down drop and hook on your descriptions, but if you see a preloaded, you always want to make sure, you know. Plus it had stated some kind of railing that I need, and I know US Express uses like those rollers, and I want to make sure I'm not picking up something that is for US Express. So anyway, confirm your information if you have any questions before you take off, because when you get to your destination, if you're not supposed to be there, you're wasting your time. All right guys, thanks for watching. Keep tuned.
All right, we are rolling out of here. Let's get going. Hope everyone's having a fantastic day or a fantastic evening. And we are about 2 hours away from our next stop. As long as I can get out of this road here. Now, a lot of guys or a lot of girls have their own system about fuel before you get loaded. Because right now, of course, I just finished up my load, right? And I have a little bit more than a half a tank. So a lot of people would go ahead and refuel. But I would recommend you not to refuel, because if you happen to go to your next delivery and they are heavy, like 45,000 plus, you might be, you know, you might be overweight. So there's times where I do travel and I only load one tank of fuel because I don't want to be over the weight limit. So that's my thing. I always fill up after I get loaded. You know, plus you want to weigh out your ticket. Once you weigh out your ticket, let's say after you get loaded and you're at, you know, 45,000 pounds, and if you want to fill up your two tanks, well, I never had a problem after doing that. That way you can show DOT, like, look, I got weighed, here's my ticket, they'll see the time stamp on it and the date. You just fueled up, and then they're gonna say okay. Now, if you guys had different experiences, please let me know in the comments. I'd like to know about that, because I never had an issue. But you know, there's always a first for everything. But yeah, what I typically do is I never fill up before my load, if I can help it. If it's a far away distance to go get my next load, well then I will fill up. But considering I have 2 hours of driving and I have a little bit more than I have, I'm not gonna do that. I'm gonna wait till I get loaded and then figure it out from there, because I might have to scale myself. And then once that is done, then I load myself. So, all right guys, that's just my opinion. That's just that's my procedure. You know, everybody does their things differently. So let me know what you guys do. All right, so we're at Rust Rock. It's supposed to be a drop and hook. However, the trailer's not ready, so they're gonna live load me. But I gotta first go to this dumpster on the right, back up to it, and he's gonna check out my trailer to make sure I'm nice and clean. Do this before, back up to a dumpster like this. It is what it is. So, I'm headed back to kind of where I came from, going to dock number 4. Anyway, let's go to this dock 4 they speak of. Was in dock 4. 4 is next to that guy. Is he leaving or what? There he is. I think he's leaving. Or he's backing. One or the other. See what he's doing. He is backing. Alright, so I'm gonna have to. Oh, he's leaving. See how he just adjusted his tandems? I believe he's gonna go. Come on, buddy, you gonna leave? Yes, he is. Get on out. Get on with your bad self, Cardinal. That's a good deal. It's a very good deal. Thank you so much. Get out of my way. There's dock four. One, two, three, four. Open up our doors. Guard shack, give him his paperwork, and then we're going to Love's to get weighed. This place was easy, just a little, you know, the attitudes of the employees that work here, definitely different from earlier this morning that I had dealt with. These people probably hate their job.
Turn right onto US 72 East.
Anyway, going to the guard shack and going to Love's. All right, so we have finished our day. It's about 2 o'clock p.m. As you guys know, I rolled early this morning. And right now I am in Alabama and I'm headed out to Kansas. No, I'm not. I'm headed to Arkansas. I'm delirious. All right, guys. So I appreciate everybody again. I hope everybody's having a wonderful day. The weather's fantastic. I'm hoping to get out of here by around 1 o'clock tomorrow morning, and I'll make my receiver probably like in 10 hours after I start. So tomorrow I'm sure I'll just be delivering this, and that is probably going to be it, and then I'll find something the next day. All right, so hope you enjoyed that today, you guys. God bless you. Take care. Well, you know what else I wanted to give a shout out to Variant, the fuel department. Man, they came through in a clutch today. Okay, so I only had maybe an hour and a half left on my clock, and I was rolling through highway, I think it's 72 out here in Alabama, and it's country. I'm talking nothing out here, and I haven't been down this way in a long time. Well, I do know 72, there's nothing out here except for construction and country and log truckers and all that good stuff. Well, I was like, man, I hope I can find a place to stay. And I passed little truck stops here and there. But, and plus I just wanted to sit down somewhere and eat, you know, instead of cooking all day. And I've always cooked my truck. And I think today I'm going to cheat a little bit and get a salad from McDonald's and just sit down and eat it. But, yeah, so I called them up and I said, hey, can you guys help me out? The fuel department. I said, can you guys help me out and tell me if there's a Love's on my route? And she goes, oh, there's a Love's right over here about 90 miles west. I said, really? Because I looked and I couldn't find it on my phone. So that's another thing. If you're in a situation where you're asking Siri to find you a Love's or a Pilot, and she's saying nothing's coming up, and you know you're going to be out of range, right, for that location, call up the fuel department. They will be more than happy to tell you if it's true or not, because they update their system all the time. Maybe my phone's not updated. So she told me within a few minutes, she's like, yeah, bud, you're going to see a Love's coming up on you in about 80 miles or so. I'm like, sweet. And so, you know, I continued on until I found this Love's, and here I am. So shout out Variant Fuel Department. Thank you so much.